Okay, welcome to the stream and review of Aliens Fireteam. Welcome to the stream and review of Aliens Fireteam. There's a long hiatus between the last Aliens game, Aliens Colonial Marines. And when I talk about aliens, I'm talking about aliens, not alien. Alien Isolation was the last Alien game, right? We know it was like more like a suspenseful horror type game, like the first movie. So we're going to have a look at this. Two of my main concerns with this game, starting off, is first of all, it's third person. It's a third person shooter. Aliens is all about being immersed, being immersive. Surely, they should have at least had a first person option, or primarily in first person, and a third person option. Maybe they can patch that and add first person. I think this is the first Aliens game that's in third person perspective. I believe that there is an Alien vs Predator mobile game where you play as the alien or predator in a third person view. The first person Aliens game was Alien vs Predator on the Atari Jaguar. 64-bit Atari Jaguar. In my personal opinion, I think Aliens vs Predator 2 for the PC is the best Aliens game ever made. Got it right here. This is the best Aliens game ever made. And then after that, the expansion pack, Primal Hunt. Best Aliens game ever made. Why oh why they don't make a modernized version of this with newer graphics. Same game engine, whether you like Stag or not. People who know Alien vs Predator 2 know what I'm talking about when I say stagger. Stagger is basically when you tap the mouse to shoot more bullets from the pulse rifle. They can balance that, they can sort out that problem, but this is like the perfect game engine. It was made by Monolith, published by Sierra, about 2001. If they just, made a HD version of this game, with all the multiplayer servers there, Survivor Mode, Team Deathmatch, Evac, all those, this would be a smash hit. Okay, I did have a little play of Aliens Fireteam yesterday, and let's start again, I'll give it another go. I'll put this back. Okay, so we're going to begin. So, right, we start in the... It looks like Verloc in... It looks a bit like Verloc in Aliens vs Predator 2. I'm going to keep going on about Alien vs Predator 2. Even though I'm playing Aliens Fireteam. Right. Hang on, let me just check my stream. Okay. Okay, so we start in the dropship bay, or whatever you call it. Let's turn up the volume. I mean, overall it looks good. This part looks good. Again, they've messed with the dropship. No. Why mess with the original stuff? Why mess with the original stuff? So I went on a tangent a little bit. I said that I had two major concerns with this game. First of all, it's in third person. I'll explain why. The second concern I have is the design of the pulse rifle. I mean, if you're not an Aliens fan, I'll show you what the pulse rifle looks like. It's the most beautiful gun ever made. It's just perfection. That is the M41A pulse rifle, like it was in Aliens. You know the saying, if it's not broke, don't fix it. Why did they bastardize the pulse rifle? Look what they've turned it into. It looks like a Nerf gun. Although Nerf is cool, they didn't need to change the design of the pulse rifle. That looks like a Lego pulse rifle. The one he has in this game. This is what the pulse rifle is meant to look like. Aliens is perfect. Oh, hello, Ray's. Hello, Ray's Wing Grathalos. Good evening. Welcome. Thank you for joining this kind of stream and review. I'm playing Aliens Fireteam for the first time. Well, actually, the second time. And I'm just like speaking about, like, yeah. I mean, Aliens is like the perfect thing. They've got the perfect vehicles, the weapons. They don't need to change anything. That's why I respect Colonial Marines, you know? I know a lot of people complained about the quality of that game and the other three, but Aliens, Colonial Marines got it down. They got the weapons correct, the sounds correct, everything correct. Dropships, the power loaders. Aliens vs Predator 2 got everything correct. Why would they change the pulse rifle? Why would they change the pulse rifle from that to this shit? It looks plastic. It's totally different. I've got another picture of the beautiful pulse rifle here. Yeah, that is a pulse rifle. One good thing about it, they got the sound correct. I'll shoot it, I'll turn up the volume, and you can hear the beautiful sound of the pulse rifle. And if that's loud enough, just pump up the volume and turn it. That's the correct sound. That is the correct sound. It has a distinct sound to it. I don't know if later on we get to use the smart gun, but yeah, thank you for coming, Razewing Rathius. Wonderful. Oh yeah, thanks for the follow the other day, by the way. Nice one, thanks a lot. Followed you back, by the way, buddy. Right, so yeah. The pulse rifle was perfect. They didn't need to mess with the pulse rifle. The dropship was perfect. They didn't need to mess with the dropship. The dropship, I don't know why they have to change stuff from Aliens. It's not cool. People, look, the customer base for this game is gonna be mostly Aliens fans, you know? So I don't see the logic of just changing it. I mean, this gun isn't bad looking really compared to normal guns, but it's not as nice as the original. Not as nice as the original. And we have Working Joes, don't we? Well, basically, similar kind of droids, working Joes. They've got the USCM logo imprinted on their shoulders. Okay, so let's jump in. I mean, overall, it looks good. It looks good. I mean, this part here definitely looks like Aliens. But I'm not getting that Aliens, authentic Aliens feel I get from Alien vs. Predator 2 on the PC. Even Aliens vs. Predator 2010, the one released in 2010 on the Xbox 360, PC and PlayStation 3. And I'm not getting the feel, the Aliens feel that I got from even Aliens Cloning Marines. And we'll jump into the first mission now. They've got kind of got the laptop correct. That's like pretty much the laptop they used for the sentry guns in the director's cut of Aliens. Okay, so
regulation cornbread contains 16 vitamins and minerals, fiber, protein, and something else I forgot. Everything except flavor.
Cornbread. Okay, I like the kind of references to the original film, the original Aliens film, cornbread. I guess she don't like the cornbread either. And then remember when Bishop hands Ripley a tray of cornbread and she slaps it out of his hand and says, "Just get away from me, Bishop. Stay away from me, Bishop. You got that?" Yeah, cornbread. I like that reference.
You and me both. Let's do this.
Okay. So yeah, excuse me if I kind of go on a bit, like, nitpick this game. I'm just a big Aliens fan, and you know, when an Aliens game is made, I want it to be made right. Not only do I want it to look like Aliens, I want it to feel like Aliens, and I think most diehard Aliens fans want that too. Okay. Oh, is it gonna start? Okay, right. Okay, priority one. Respond to a distress call from Katanga Refinery. Locate and extract Dr. Timothy Hoiniker, a Weyland Yutani scientist. His safety is in your hands. Okay, let's go. And go standard. Launch the mission. I'm just playing with bots for now.
Fire team, this is a rescue mission. You're boarding Katanga, a derelict orbital refinery.
Okay.
Ingress is via the forward airlock.
Let's get comfortable.
Locate, secure, and evac Dr. Tim Honaker, a Weyland Yutani scientist. Mount up, people.
Don't know if you can see the alien on my t-shirt. Clearly. Or unclearly. Oh, ready. Let's click ready. That would be a good idea.
I want to be clear, Shorebody. Anyone who pukes in my bird cleans my bird.
Yes, priority one, ingress. Fighting, this is a rescue mission, you're boarding Katanga, da 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 da. Yeah, ingress via the forward airlock. You will locate secure Dr. Evac, Dr. Honaker, Weyland Yutani scientist, blah blah blah. Okay. Something.
You gotta ping on Dr. Honaker's personal data transmitter. He's not far in.
I don't remember any
first,
of these
we need a deck plan.
Doors.
Pull one out the terminal and fluorine extraction.
I don't remember any of these doors in Aliens, in any of the Aliens films. I mean, don't do that. They don't need to have doors that look like that, really. Everything should be based off of the Aliens film, in my opinion. Ooh. the overall impression I'm getting, this could be like any kind of space shooter game. This could be any kind of space shooting game. It doesn't replicate Hagley's Hope. It doesn't replicate LV-426.
Just emergency lights.
And I know...
And maybe we can kick the backup power after we grab Honecker.
Yes, I know that some people may say this game is not meant to mimic exactly the Aliens film and LV-426. But my argument is, it should. We've been waiting a very long time for an Aliens game. Okay, right. Let's get to the shooting.
Patch into the console. I'll pull it down over wireless. Give me a second. I got a deck plan. Backup generator is beyond Honecker's ping. We can kick it after we grab him.
Okay, so the red grating on the floor,
the junction ahead.
The pipes along the walls, the steam coming from the sides, the ceilings, the red panels on the ceiling, walls. This looks more authentic, looking at it. The steam does no damage, by the way. This looks more authentic than other parts of this game.
Honecker, this is the Colonial Marines. You hearing me?
The sound? The music? Is appropriate. Feels very alien-esque.
Acid damage. Not encouraging. Continue your sweep.
Acid damage. I like the panels. I mean, like, these are like the ones on the Nostromo, isn't it? And on the Sevastopol in Alien Isolation. It's always fun to shoot barrels. Two bots with us, two androids. It'd be better if there were two humans, two fellow Marines.
Should be right here.
Here we go.
High speed incoming, get hot.
The sound of the motion tracker's good. Pretty accurate. It's not blue, like exactly like the one from Aliens, which is going to bother me a bit.
We are
on the. I mean, we are in a like, I guess like a similar place to LV-426. Why are all the aliens? Why are so many of the aliens? Runners, why are they dog aliens? Why like the dog alien here? The dog alien.
Hey,
here.
On the deck, Honecker's PDT chip.
Why are they dog aliens? Why are there so many dog aliens in this game? So many runners. Some other people call it the bull alien or the cow alien. I call it the dog alien or runner. Why are there so many? Do they have a lot of dogs on this colony? It's an aliens game. They should start off with warrior aliens. Aliens and warriors. Just like this one here. Yeah? The Aliens Warrior. They should mostly be these aliens. Mostly. Maybe a few runners. Chuck a few runners in for fun. They should not be the staple aliens of the game. That's another criticism. Too many runners. Doors inappropriate.
Sloppy work. Miss Honecker went this way.
And okay, I'm opening the door with a welder or soldering iron, welder thing. And you just press square. Why? Why don't you just press another button, pull out the blowtorch, and then just make it more interactive experience than just pressing square. In Aliens vs. Predator 2 on the PC, released in 2001, you actually pull out the blowtorch and then you literally put it on where you need to. It's more like using it in real life. But nowadays, no, you just hold down square. Not immersive, not realistic, unauthentic.
I got an idea how to track down Honecker. Searching this whole barge would take too long. Movement, tell you my idea later.
Here we go, more runner aliens. Oh, let's use the fake pulse one. Plus, if these are runners, does a description pop up what they are? Because if you've got the prowler, does it say what they are? No, it's just... Okay, these are clearly supposed to be dog aliens. Okay, let me just pause it right there. So, the majority of these aliens... Can I pause the game? Why is the game continuing? Ah. So, let me just explode. Out of the way. So, one of my pet peeves with this game. The majority of the aliens are runner aliens. Dog aliens from Alien 3. Why? Why are they not aliens warriors? Very, very strange indeed. Very strange. Why couldn't I pause the game? I press start. I'm not in an online game. Looks like I'm gonna complain about this game.
Rebooting.
All the way through. So if you're a fan of this, maybe, I don't know, maybe. This isn't a cartoon, this isn't a comic book. Why make up all these aliens like the Exploder alien, and the Prowler, and the Spitter? They can add all those in later for fun, but you've got to have your staples. You'll have the Aliens Warrior first of all. And by the way, if they're meant to be runner aliens, they're not big enough. Runner aliens, dog aliens, they have massive heads, bigger than the warrior alien. So, I mean, not only do they have runners inappropriately, they haven't even done the runners correctly. They've got to be much bigger than that. Have you seen Alien 3? If you've seen Alien 3, you will know what runners are supposed to look like, right? You see the bit where it comes out of the tunnel and it drags the man. How big its head is in proportion to the human body. It's flipping huge. Ah, and one thing they haven't... I'll continue playing. Let's try and look at some good points of this game. It's got aliens. It's got marines. And it's got kind of pulse rifles. Station locks. So far.
I found a data access point, but it's further in. Concentrate on getting the power up.
So far, this is very mediocre.
Listen.
Actually, the more I play this, the more I just want to play Alien vs. Predator 2. Oh, fuck off. You bastard. I mean, that is a cool design for an alien.
Never seen so much acid in one bug. Where did these come from?
Really cool design for an alien, but... Add them later. Aliens Colonial Marines did it perfectly. They had Aliens Warriors as the staple. They chucked in a few runners and a few different variations. Fine, that's absolutely fine. But you've got to have the main aliens in it first. Oh, I'm liking these corridors. Looks very much like Hadley's Hope.
Dynamo rooms just ahead. Restart's mostly automated.
But yeah, these are way too small. Absolutely tiny for dog aliens. Maybe the argument is they can be juvenile dog aliens, juvenile runners. I mean, in proportion to his leg, no way. That's not a full blown runner. Yeah, apologies if I'm actually complaining a lot about this game, but I mean, it's been a long time since the last Aliens game, and it's been a long time, so Aliens fans are thirsty for a good game, you know? We've got high expectations. We love the franchise very much. Another point I was going to talk about actually as well. You can't jump, or not from what I can tell. You can't jump, you can just roll.
Assistance required.
I mean, you can't crouch. You can't even crouch. The aliens all crawl. Okay, I know the runner alien is supposed to be on all fours, but even the prowler is on all fours. A lot of aliens should be standing up on two legs and running towards you.
Spinning this up is gonna make noise, vibration, heat, whatever bugs key off, they'll catch it. Be ready for a fight when you switch on.
What I do like about this, you can deploy sentry guns, which I'm about to do.
I got you.
I'm pressing the wrong buttons. There we go. Put it there.
Sentry deployed.
Thank you. The sentry gun doesn't look exactly like the one in Aliens. That bothers me as an Aliens fan. And it doesn't need a bloody laser pointer. It doesn't need a visible laser pointer sticking out of it. That's stupid. I really thought I'd be able to say, like, more positive things about this, but I can't. Based on Hadley's Hope, I mean the whole film.
Bypassing death.
It was based on, set in Hadley's Hope. This game looks like it's set on Hadley's No Hope. The pulse rifle doesn't look implanted. These runner aliens are tiny, they shouldn't be runner aliens anyway. Why do I have two working Joes next to me side by side? It's weird. We want fellow Marines. Even if it's single player, multiplayer, it doesn't matter, they should be Marines. When the androids get hit, they should have like that milky blood. I mean, that milky blood is like a part of Alien's lore. That started in Alien with Ash. And then later Bishop, isn't it? When he accidentally cut his finger doing the trick with Hudson's fingers with a knife. Oh, here we go. That's a more authentic. Yeah, that's a xenomorph alien warrior. It is a bit too tall compared to what they should be, judging by the films and the other games, but that's more like it. Ah, like a shotgun. Fuck you. Have that. I like to keep this handy for close encounters. That's nice. The aliens warrior is nice, and they got the head sculpt.
Keep heading aft toward the core.
Down. Let's zoom in. Yeah, that's a nice alien. I don't know how it got so big though. Did a facehugger jump on a giant? Did it impregnate a giant? But yeah, anyway, I like that. I like that alien. Should be more like that. Again, look at that runner. Runner's absolutely tiny. But looking close, I mean, it is really accurate. Like, the sculpt is accurate, the shape of the alien is accurate. The mouth, the inner jaw, that really does look like a dog alien up close, but its proportions are all wrong. It should be much bigger than that. Much, much bigger. Much bigger. Much more bigger in it, mate. Oh, here we go, more.
Bypassing damage.
Grabbing ammo.
Maybe it just lacks atmosphere because it's not in first person. I really hope they'll patch in a first person perspective later on. Don't know if they will, I don't know if they can. It's like a little puppy alien. This is a little puppy alien. It's not even a... And when you step in the acid, it doesn't do anything. It doesn't do anything. The acid looks like Predator's blood. It doesn't look like the acid in Aliens. The acid in Aliens looks more yellowish. This kind of glows like Predator's blood. Maybe I set my expectations too high for this game. What was I going to... I was going to do something. I'll do a bit in a minute. Yeah, what was I going to do? I was going to do something. Ah, 2 seconds. Oh, we've got more. I don't know why it doesn't pause. Okay, let's... Shit.
Patching up.
Not every game, made nowadays has to follow the game mechanics of every modern game. They can go back to the old way, like they can have medipacks on the floor, you can just walk over them. Armour on the floor, you can just walk over it. You don't have to press a button to do it. I honestly think if they reskin Aliens vs Predator 2 and put it in a modern package, but with the same game mechanics, it will be a smash hit, I tell you. Banned for my own chat.
Required. Shut down imminent. Rebooting.
I like these corridors, they're very alien-esque, nice, very cool, very authentic. The aliens are not making the correct sounds. Doing anything. Arsehole. Let's give it another go. Unless I'm doing something wrong, I don't know why it's starting me from the back from the beginning again.
Hey, best advice I got? Get yourself a good pair of earplugs to sleep, huh? There's always something in here clanging or humming. Just make sure you can still hear the alarms, huh? Bring me back something nice.
I'll bring you back a face hugger.
Fireteam, this
I'm
is a rescue
standard.
Mission. You're boarding Katanga, a derelict orbital refinery.
That pulse
ingress
rifle
is
was
via
just
the forward
wrong.
Airlock. You'll locate, secure, and evac Dr. Tim Pump.
Thank you.
personal data transmitter.
Why do we have to start? Why do we have to start from square one again?
First, we need a deck plan. Pull one off a terminal and chlorine extraction.
Can we just focus on trying to get past them to the next mission?
And maybe we can kick the backup power after we grab.
I'm just gonna focus on getting to the next mission and try and play my best, and then let's see the rest of the game.
Patch into the console, I'll pull it down over wireless.
Right now, I mean, it looks like an Aliens game, kind of. Does it feel like an Aliens game? Absolutely not.
Honaker, this is the Colonial Marines. You hearing me? Acid damage. Not encouraging. Continue your sweep.
There's no crosshair. If you don't zoom in and press the L trigger, there's no crosshair. The secondary view, I mean, it's okay. Are you supposed to use it all the time? You can't use it all the time. It's got to recharge. So to get across, you have no crosshair, or you've got to zoom in. That is weird. Really weird.
High speed incoming, get hot. Short bursts.
Short control bursts. Nice reference to Control Hicks's advice.
Way more than I expected.
Hudson and Buskowitz. Remember, short control bursts.
Watch the routing.
Gotta conserve that ammo, you know.
Too many.
Too many ground aliens, too many dog aliens. Why? This is an Alien 3. And even if it was, there was only one. Oh, dog alien on that ship. Anyway. I got a quick wiping.
So many. Honaker's PDT chip. Cut it out. But why? Door's welded shut. Sloppy work.
Like I said, in Aliens vs. Predator 2, you press a button, you change weapon, you bring out the blowtorch, you press T, and then you hold down the button, and you actually use the blowtorch in the game. Now, you just hold down square. That's sad. That's very sad.
Listen.
It's not a bad looking game overall, but
hey, I got an idea how to track down Honaker.
This is a very mediocre shooting game with an aliens package.
Movement, tell you my
I'm
idea
not
leader.
Fooled by this. I'm not fooled by this one iota. My battery is low. Thank you. pulse rifle's got a nice rumble to it.
I don't recognize this form.
That's a big one. What is that? What is that one?
I'll get into analyzing that. She's a Battalion synthetic. Keep moving after.
The sounds of the aliens are not authentic. They sound a bit alien-esque, but they're not movie accurate. Alpha. Alien Alpha. Run into the vents. Why is he so scared? It's massive. And again, this vent's not even textured. I remember a review of Aliens Colonial Marines. They criticised Aliens Colonial Marines because the vents weren't textured. What's their excuse? This is not textured. Coward alien. Run away.
Patching up.
Patching up. That's like the alien from the first movie, pretty much. The big chap. Yeah, that's the big chap. He didn't spawn in earlier.
Damage.
now I'm getting into it, I mean, without picking up the forks, it is quite enjoyable so far.
Well, Lister reviews the data, you can get the power up. Dynamo room just ahead.
Feels quite good. If you just focus on the game and without comparing it to the original movie and the other Aliens games, it's quite enjoyable, but
bypassing damage.
Yeah, let's try and get to the next mission. Burst. They're supposed to be like these ones from Aliens Colonial Marines, those bursters, I believe. They're supposed to be like these, right? This one's from Aliens Colonial Marines. I think this one looks nicer. I don't like the fact you can't pause this game. I'm down.
Bypassing damage.
Pick me up, motherfucker.
Rebooting.
Hey.
Rebooting.
It's absolutely ridiculous you can't pause the game. That is a pretty cool new design for an alien, though, definitely. Super warrior alien, right? In Aliens vs. Predator 2010, they had quite a few runners, but not at the beginning. Another problem with this pulse rifle is actually not just how the aesthetics, it's the functionality. It doesn't have the under action pump grenade launcher. It should have the grenade launcher. There's nothing quite like pressing another button and then shooting grenades. But no, you have to shoot and then throw grenades separately, which is stupid. You've got the perfect weapon, the pulse rifle. You've taken off the grenade launcher. Why would you take off the grenade launcher? Were these really Aliens fans who helped develop this game, who helped make this game? I don't know if they were. Or was it just game developers who knew something about Aliens? But not enough. Anyway, yeah, let's focus on the game. Stop getting annoyed about the floors, the many floors, more floors than the skyscraper. Let's try and make it for the next mission, if not then fuck it. This game is not gripping me.
I have completed my analysis. 2 weeks ago, the mainframe on Deck 41 was accessed, I believe, by Dr. Honecker.
Marines, head to the core lift. Big freight elevator goes all the way up the main tower.
Burking them. Should I burk them? I'll burk them. Can you burk your own bots? You fucking bots. I want marines, you cunts. I want fucking marines. I'm gonna burk you. Burk you.
On your toes, fire team. On the flank.
On the flank behind. Why do we have this person like speaking to us all the time? We've got motion trackers, we don't need her. We don't need her telling us. She's just a useless, irritating person. We don't need a controller. Just she should be able to. I guess we could switch it up, the controller's voice. Well, I bloody hope so. But I can't even pause the game to find out, and I'm not even playing online. This game is pissing me off. Let it eat him. Just eat him. You aren't getting any nutrition from silicon and what is it, aluminium, hardened steel, or whatever, titanium, whatever the fuck you're made of. Fuck you. Can't even crouch down to teabag the cunt. You revive him. I'm saving my stims for me. And I haven't got any left anyway. Or do you use stims? I think they like them. come down. That trophy's got... The name of that trophy's got nothing to do with aliens. Oh. If it's to do with Gwen. The face hugger in the stasis chamber goes for Bert by him. Oh, he likes you. Maybe that's a east.
I'm gonna shortcut you through the refinery core.
Throw back to
you'll
that.
Get a nice view too. You're welcome.
This person on the mic is just irritating. Like that glitched. He kind of like blipped around the corner and then blipped back in and like a hologram. I'm really trying to like this game, you know. I'm really trying to like it. Because I like aliens, and it's an aliens game, and I like aliens, and it's an aliens game, but this is not a good aliens game. You can just get a feel for a game straight away, can't you? Where are we going? Turn left. Wonder if later on in the game you can go through vents and that. That'd be really... I was going to say that'd be really
when,
cool, but it's an aliens
chopper,
game. You should be going through vents sometimes.
Okay,
let's try... Arsehole. Got no skins left. Some stims.
We don't find this guy alive. I'm gonna kill him.
Here we are. Wave after wave of brainless runners. Waypoint for other players. what's that? Reloads 25% of your current weapon's ammunition. With rounds that may briefly. Okay, whatever.
Let's run. Mind up.
I'm wondering, nowadays, do game developers hate Aliens fans? Okay, let's start then. Let's start.
Signal.
So it should be. It's an aliens game. We haven't come here to play Tiddlywinks, have we? It's very linear. They can only come through here. They can only come through this corridor, or this path, and through this path. They can't come through the gaps. They can't come through here. They can't even come from the ceiling. They don't come from this gap. No. Just linear pathways. Destroyed the sentry gun.
Just another minute. Got it.
Wonderful.
Rick, like, give it up.
Fuck off. Don't spit. It's very impolite to spit. You've got to recharge your crosshair. The first game ever to have a crosshair as a power up. Give us shit. Get off. Standing there like a big dummy.
Into the elevator, haul ass, Marines.
Come down, please.
Fuck off, you big fat alien. Oh, fucking hell. We're fucked.
Shut down imminent.
Where's the other Marine? The other robot? No.
Santos, my fire team is off the board.
My overall impression of this game is not very good. It feels a bit like it's just a generic shooter with an aliens kind of packaging, and even a good aliens packaging. It's inaccurate. There's so many things wrong with it. If you're talking about the Aliens franchise, the pulse rifle's wrong, totally wrong. They don't, and the functionality as well doesn't have it under pump action grenade launcher. You should be able to press another button and launch a grenade from the pulse rifle. That's disgusting. Why would they do that to the pulse rifle? A lot of the doors look wrong. They don't fit into the Aliens films. And there's wave after wave of runner aliens. I don't understand why in an Aliens game would they have wave after wave of runner aliens. Why? Do they know the alien life cycle? Do they understand the biology of the alien? You only get runners when a facehugger impregnates a dog. Or a bull, or a cow, or however you whether you prefer the director's cut or the original cut, the cinematic theatrical release. How would I improve this game? Well, they need more warrior aliens. Yeah, the staple has to be warrior aliens first. Upright walking warrior aliens. And they can throw in some runners for some fun, just to mix it up a bit. And then these new designs of aliens, their Prowler and Burster and all that stuff, that's fun. But that should not be the main alien wave. That should not be the staple of the main aliens waves. And looking at the sounds of the aliens are totally inaccurate. They're not movie accurate at all. They sound a bit like aliens, but they're not. They don't sound like the ones from the movie. And then looking at this lobby, looking at this dropship. That is not the dropship from Aliens. When you make an Aliens game, it should be like the film. That's the whole point of making an Aliens game. Like, let me show you the dropship. We haven't even seen an APC yet. Why is there not an APC? I'll have a look around. There must be an APC in this lobby. There must be. This is a dropship from Aliens. Even on this little model, you can see where the gun is supposed to be. It's like a mini gun on the front. Then you've got the rockets on the sides. Let's see if it will focus. That is a correct, accurate, movie accurate dropship. What is that monstrosity? Where on earth did they dig that up from? It's disgusting. I will continue to play this game. I will finish this game and I will stream this game. But it is not thoroughly enjoyable. It is not a thoroughly enjoyable, authentic Aliens experience so far. I hope it improves with the missions, with the later missions. I like the touch, like they've got like the Marines sitting here on the containers, on the boxes, and the chains dangling down. I mean, they did try in a way. Really? But, like I said, it's not. Just like looking at it, just quickly looking at it, you can't tell it's an Aliens game straight away. Okay, you can buy these, they had these things in the movie, these kind of columns. dropship's wrong. I keep saying that the dropship's wrong. Where's the APC? Do we have an APC? Come on. You've got to have an APC. Like, you're an Aliens fan. You've been waiting years for an Aliens game. And when you get into it, you want to know, bang, this is Aliens. This is Aliens. The APC must be in the lobby. Okay, they've got the USCM logo here. Good. Good. They could have added the sticker. They haven't even added like a funny sticker like they did in the movie, like a throwback to the movie, like "We Endanger Species," something like that, you know, or something similar to that. I just don't know why they would make an Aliens game like this. It's like a sugar-free soft drink. Yeah? You kind of get the idea of the taste of it, or of what the real original soft drink tastes like, but then you get a horrible aftertaste of artificial sweetness. No power loader in the lobby as well. Oh, here we go. We've got a power loader here. Okay, that's good. We've got a power loader. Okay, good. Where's the APC? We've got to have an APC in the lobby, man. Come on. There should be power loaders, like walking back and forth from carrying and loading stuff and all that stuff. It's a very mediocre Aliens experience. It could have been excellent. They could have made it superb. They could have made it spectacular. Okay. I'll stream it again later. I'll stream it and see how the other missions are. But right now, I'm not impressed. I'll also play multiplayer as well later. So let's end this game now. Load out inventory. I want to go back to the lobby, please. Tactical opportunities. Hunt xenomorph eggs. L1 campaigns. Load out inventory settings. Team. How do you get into online multiplayer? I just want to see how you do it before I end this stream. Launch mission. Matchmaking private. Oh, okay, you just go to public. Populate your fire team with other. Okay, that'll do for today in kind of like a review. My initial impressions of the game, the mechanics, and the graphics, and all that stuff. So thank you for watching, and see you later. Time for hypersleep.